Hi, folks. How you doing? Hey, this is how I watch a hockey game, just like you people do. I got my TV. I'm down my basement. I got my beautiful goldfish, as everybody knows. But most of all, I have my beautiful chair. This chair I've had since the 60s, way back 40. It's seen a lot of hockey games, and it's seen a few suns go down, too. You know, I remember, though, when I was unemployed. I didn't have a job, so I bought this when I was unemployed down in Rochester, New York. Never had a job, and I listened to Bobby Orr. You remember when he scored that great goal flying through the air? And I said, what am I going to do? I don't have a job. I couldn't get a job sweeping floors. I couldn't get anything. And I said, dear God, help me out here. Let me do something. Help me do. I made a comeback. And 4 years from the day I heard Bobby score that goal, I was coaching Bobby Orr. So thank you, God. I just wanted to say that. You kids say your prayers every night. Anyhow, back then they had hip picks, boy. You couldn't believe. Got them now, too. But we've got a few. You ready to go? Let's see those hip checks. Okay, here we go. These are classic hip checks from today and to the early 50s. Here's New York's Brad Park on Johnny Music. My buddy Brian Marchman. Hey, don't think the rocket couldn't dish it out too. Watch these saves. Players think they're in. Not so fast, Kowalski. Cold egg robs Hernina. Hey, Brathwaite dives back in the nick of time. Barasa on Leclerc. Abishur on Morrison. Dunham dives back. Poche robs Vincent. Hey, Cujo bails out my buddy Parchman. Gub Worsley with a beauty. Way to go, Gubber. Dennis DeJordy. Thibault on Ryan Smith. Shields. Frankenhauser, super. Byron with an unbelievable stick save on Delmar. Trevor Kidd with a nice glove save. Thibault again. Shields again. Jacques Blond knocks it down just in time. Eddie Johnson with a nice stick save. Gagher, remember this one in the playoffs a few years ago? Whoa! Shields with another great one. Salo. Lalime, nice one. Hey, Malarchuk, this is one of the best saves. Brantford with a great one. Rhodes on Leclerc. Kiprasov with a great one. Lalime. Longo, a diving save. Beaupre on Ricci. Too bad, Mike.
You know, there's a couple of terms I want to get straightened out. I remember McLean were on Coach's Corner, and I remember that commercial they had. They had the guy hitting the puck up in the air as they walked out, and the guard said, boy, he could really dangle. And I said to McLean, you know, they're all wrong. That doesn't mean dangle, and the truck even put in dangle means something hanging and everything. Dangle, as everybody knows in hockey, means you can really fly out there with the puck. He can dangle. And I remember Muckler, come on, John Muckler, come on. I said, ask John. So he asked him, and he said, you can skate fast. So dangle means dangle with that puck. So you got all that, eh? A dangle is when a player motors with the puck. Like Berard. Watch Denny Severn. Bertuzzi, a dangle and a straight arm. A Russian rocket, Pavel Bure. Hey, Samsonov, a dangle and a how's she going? The Avs, Corbeil. Tchaikovsky. Rosie Raziska. Hey, even back in the 40s, they could dangle. Hey, funny looking at the dark ice, eh? Hall of Fame, Doug Harvey shows some speed and a nice shot. Niedermeyer blows by the Bruins defense. Naslund, hey, this is not a dangle, but I wanted to show it anyway. Now this is a dangle. Okay, not much of a dangle, but a nice one. Jean Beliveau. A beauty and Dan. Hey, here's Niedermeyer with a classic Bobby Orr rush. Beauty. Drury. Hey, here's one of my favorites, Patrick Marleau with an end-to-ender. Now look, I gotta admit, the hip checks were flashy, but I'll tell you something. When you get caught in the trolley tracks, it's serious business. As you know, the trolley tracks are when you cut into center and you can't get out of the tracks. Hey, it's your nightmare and a defenseman's dream. And once you get in the trolley tracks, no mercy is shown. And here's what I call a suey pass. In other words, a suicide pass. You know, kids, if you look up and you see one of your teammates looking back for a pass at center ice, you know another guy's coming, don't give it to him. That's what we call a suicide pass. That's when they get hurt. Folks, these shots are a goalie's nightmare. Let me tell you, they hate these shots. All right, let's see them.
30 from 191 as it bounces in.
A clear in by Peter Stastny, right through Patrick.
Hey, watch it bounce on Patrick.
Up and over. Every goaltender's nightmare.
Paul Cavallini puts one off the glass and in. Yeah, here's a tough one on my buddy, Brucey Gamble.
Oh,
91 on Frank Pietrangelo from center. It even happens to the best of them. Hey, poor Rasico. You know, when the puck takes a bounce like this at the last minute, there's not much a goalie can do. Hey, watch out for the post, Mike. Don't hurt yourself. Barassa gets his stick stuck. Hey, Patrick Waugh with a nice move on the great one. Hey, Patrick, you can't do that. Hey, Patrick gets hit. Blow the whistle, blow the whistle. Hey, tough going for Patrick. And he's not too happy.
You see the shot coming from the point. Don't really know on that.
Hey, Hextall gets a little upset here.
Certainly upset about it.
It's a feeding frenzy right now.
Hey, that's what I like. Goalie with emotion.
Frank Mihalovic collects the winner on a rebound. Plumlee didn't need this stick anymore that night anyway.
All right, sitting in my beautiful chair here, I've seen some great playoff goals, let me tell you. And I've got some of my favorites and some of my not-so-favorites, if you know what I mean.
Me and the Bruins, Guy Lafleur, Scotty Bowman, and the Canadiens. Nifty Middleton puts us up one zip. Watch Savard make a big save on my buddy Stan Jonathan. They tie it up in a power play. What else? Wayne Cashman played unbelievable in the series. He puts us up 2-1. Then he walks out and puts it under Dryden's arm. We're up 3-1. They cut it to 3-2 in a power play. What else again? Then Guy feeds Savard on another power play, and it's tied at 3. Unbelievable, the power plays. But late in the third, Ricky Middleton scores to make it 4-3. Way to go, Nifty. Here's a play that sent me on the road to Coach's Corner.
Tell us how the play started now. You picked it up in your own end, right?
Yeah, I gave it to Lemaire, and Lemaire went inside the blue line. About maybe
looked offside to me, too.
No, it wasn't. About 25 feet inside, drop it back, and Gilbert was in the net.
Yeah, he'd played great up until then.
He still talked to me about it in Quebec City.
Does he?
Yeah.
Well, right along the ice again. When you get in there, you hum there all along the ice all the time, didn't you?
Close my eye again.
Yeah, again, yeah. You guys always close his eye.
I still say it was offside. Now to look at some more great playoff goals. Looks like Mario said, look, I'm going to get this puck, and I'm going to score, and nobody's going to stop me. And he did it.
Oh, baby.
A year to the day, watch this classic on the Bruins top corner again.
Trying to fool Mark and does. Look out. Scores.
Have you ever seen such finesse?
Now my buddy Bobby Schmutz sips one home.
Marcotte. Shepherd moving in. Center for Scott. He scores! Smots! And the series is tied.
Hey, I love those Boston crowds. They love the Bruins, and that's my number one fan.
Gilmore, Fleury.
Fleury gets a nice one and sends the Battle of Alberta to Game 7.
Messier gets it away. Here's Fleury looking for his first goal of the series. Scores!
Nice slide. That's okay after OT goes. Are they happy or what? Phil Mirocco scores his last goal to win the Stanley Cup, just like the tragically hip song says. Howie Meeker puts it in front, and Billy pops it home for the winner. This one is the greatest comeback of all time in any sport, as far as I'm concerned. I was doing the color. Darrell Evans wins it in overtime. The Kings scored unbelievable 5 straight goals in the third to tie it up. I was doing the color with Bob Cole. I never heard a crowd go as nuts as that.
Fashion here tonight, the greatest comeback that I can remember in Stanley Cup play.
René Robert scores against Bernie Perron, and you remember this one. This was a famous fog game. Great shot. René put it along the ice, and Perron lost it in the fog. Way to go, René. Peter Stastny scores a winner in overtime in Game 7. You know, they talk about the Battle of Alberta. The Battle of Quebec was just as vicious, if not more so. Hey, speaking of the Battle of Alberta, watch the great one score in overtime. It was shorthanded, no less. Hey, it helped the Oilers sweep the Flames.
Gretzky going in, Suter trying to get back. Gretzky with a shot, he scores!
Watch him wire this one. That's a smoker, top corner.
It's a shorthanded goal.
Brett Hall, was his foot in the crease or not? Brett with the winner in Game 6 of the final. Hey, the rule that year was if your skate is in the crease, it was no goal. Hey, I don't know. I said it was in the crease. Yeah, so what? He was in the crease. What's the difference? Dallas wins the cup. Folks, I've seen them all, and to me, this guy was the greatest goalie who ever lived. Hey, Terry had black eyes here. That's why he's wearing the sunglasses. Hey, let's just go over Terry's stuff just to see how good he was. Most wins by a rookie goalie with 44, and the winner of the Calder Trophy, which is a rookie. Most shutouts in a career with 103. He won 44 games 2 years in a row. Unbelievable. Second only to Patrick Waugh for career wins and games played. 4 Stanley Cups, 4 Vezinas, and over 100 playoff games, he had 12 shutouts and an average of 2.5. Holy smokes. No, Terry was a great guy. I was at a couple of training camps that he was at. And one day I was walking along the street with 3 of my minor league buddies, and he was walking the other way. He knew me, but he didn't know my name. He stopped and shook my hand. He made me feel so good. Anyhow, as far as I'm concerned, and a lot of people are concerned, the greatest goaltender who ever lived, Terry Sawchuk. If I had to win one game and I could pick any goalie playing to start for me, of course it would be Marty Brodeur. 3 Stanley Cups, a gold medal, world championship, rookie of the year, and back-to-back Vezinas. The one thing I love about Marty, he always seems so cool in the net. He never panics. How about this? Over 400 wins, 75 shutouts, and believe me, in that playoff, Marty shines. In 140 games, Marty has 84 wins and has an average of 1.87. Unbelievable. When he's in a net, you always have a chance to win, that's for sure. Marty Brodeur, the best goalie played in the National Hockey League. Davey Yzerman. Now this is a hockey player's hockey player. Ex-Peterborough Pete little Stevie Wonder can do it all. He can dangle, he can handle a puck with the best of him, and boy, can he score. Watch these beauty goals. Yeah, and I'll tell you another thing. He's the most respected hockey player in the game today. The two-time Stanley Cup winner has played 190 playoff games and has 181 points. Not too shabby, eh? He's one of the best and one of my favorites of all time, Stevie Wonder Yzerman. Hey, when you think of a wrist shot, you think of Burnaby's Joe Sakic. If anybody had a better wrist shot in the history of the NHL, I haven't seen it. Hey, his wrist shot explodes. Know how he got it? I'll tell you how. You know, I asked Joe, I said, Joe, how'd you ever get that great wrist shot? Well, he tells me. He was down in the basement. He'd have pails of puck. Whatever he shot at, it was aluminum or something. So his dad would be upstairs in the living room reading the paper, and if Joe stopped shooting, he wouldn't hear the noise. Then he'd say, Joe, what are you doing? Joe would have to get back to shooting. Hour after hour, he'd shoot it, and that's how he got the great wrist shot. Joe's a two-time Stanley Cup winner and a gold medal winner, too. He's won the Lady Byng, I won't hold that against him, and a Hart Trophy in 2001. Nice pass to Raymond. And another nice pass to Raymond. Guys ask me who way back could play in the NHL today. I always say the Rocket for sure, Belleville, Hall, and Gordie Howe. But the more I watch tapes of Timmy Horton, I would put him up in that category too. He's one of the most underrated players in the NHL of all time, as far as I'm concerned. He was one of the best carrying the puck, and he could dish it off. He was a great skater and one of the strongest players ever to play the game. Timmy loved to rush for the puck, and when you rush for the puck, you better not cut into center ice. This hit on Timmy by Bill Gazman is one of the most vicious hits of all time. Poor Timmy broke his jaw and leg on this one hit. But he came back and played the next season. The four-time Stanley Cup champion played 24 seasons in the National Hockey League. Only Messier and Howe have played more. Hey, he can hammer a puck as well. Timmy was one of the all-time greats as far as I'm concerned and one of the most all-time underrated. I only met him a couple of times at training camp, and he was one of the nicest guys I've ever met.
You know, folks, one of the hardest hitters I've ever seen in my life is Bobby Bond when he played for the Toronto Maple Leafs. This guy used to come out and crunch him like you couldn't believe. Bawango, you couldn't believe it. You know, he taught me a valuable lesson when I was a rookie. I was standing around watching a fight. He come up behind me, put his arm around me, around the neck, started to choke me. Guys fell on me. I thought I was going to die. Nobody ever did that to me again. Thank you, Bobby. Thank you. But he's got some hits coming for you. Watch this. You get a guy in the trolley tracks, and it was curtains.
Yeah, it was just, it was a lot of fun. We had, our wingers really helped a lot in those days, though. You know, we had those guys coming
back. Steer them in, eh?
And they could just cut those outside off for us, and Al would stand up a little bit, and the guy'd have to turn into the center ice, and I'd be there.
Oh, Gonzo, I'll tell you, boy.
When Bobby Bond was on the ice, you better keep your head up. He was murder on center ice, and he was just as tough along the boards. As I found out in my rookie year, he could really throw them. Bobby Bond, one of the hardest hitters back in my day. Yeah. 6'3", 200 pounds, Rob Blake from Simcoe, Ontario, is the hardest hitter in the game today. Rob was a Norris Trophy winner in 1998 and a first-team All-Star that same year. Yet he was also an anchor on the gold medal-winning Team Canada in the 2002 Salt Lake City Games. Hey, like Bond, you better keep your head up when Rob's on the ice. Hey, watch, he kind of backs into the players. If you were going to start a team and you could only pick one player to build your team around, Rob wouldn't be a bad choice, I'll tell you. Now that Stevens is retired, look at those eyes. The hardest hitter of all time, hands down, is 6'2", 215 pounds, Kitchener, Ontario native Scott Stevens. If you were cutting across center ice with Scott on the ice, you were asking for trouble. Scott is a three-time Stanley Cup champion, the 2000 Conn Smythe winner, and played in 13 All-Star games. And can you believe it? He never won a Norris Trophy. That's nuts. Scott made a lot of guys pay the price, I'll tell you. Defense partner Brian Rafalski is forcing the Canes player to cut to the center. Scott sees this and makes his move. Hey, Scott and Eric had a thing going. In the 2000 playoffs, Eric was out for a long time with an injury. He came back for Game 6 against the Devils. You know, I come on coach's corner and said, Eric is nuts playing. And he better watch out because he's not sharp. And guys like Stevens are right in the thick of the battle. They're sharp. But watch what happened in Game 7. Hey, Eric, come back next year. Scott Stevens, three-time Stanley Cup champion and the NHL's hardest hitter of all time. Okay, folks, time for some club saves from then and now, starting with Jerry Cheevers on Brad Park. Hey, here's Jerry in his rookie year with no mask. Richter. Lucci. Denny. Dunham. Cujo. Muir. Barrasso. Omen. Turek, a beauty by my buddy Gary Smith. Al Rollins with two nice ones. Johnny Bauer. E. Hamer. Tyler Moss. Salo. Hasek. Richter again. Billy Radford. Weeks, Denny again, Snow, Jablonski, Eddie Johnson, Glenn Hall. Hey, here's Johnny Bauer again with two beauties. Moog on the great one. Van Beesbrook. Salo. The Boolin Wall, Putfan, Roy, JVB again, Glenn Hall with two. Salo. Cujo off the post and into the glove. The Longo. Osgood. Starting off with two beauties by JR. Boy, they're gonna love him in LA. Garen with a funny one. And here's a Russian rocket, Pavel Bure, with some sweet hands. Forsberg from in close. Donato. Pavel Dimitri holds and roofs it. Dickie Duff with a beauty. Mike York with a nice move. Dougie Waite. Dadzuk walks in, nice. Bob Airy on the Sharks. Peter Forsberg with some nice moves. Hey, somebody hit him. John Beliveau looks like Berio here. Or should I say Berio looks like Beliveau? Here's a rocket in a classic. All Korea, boy, can he dangle. Here's Mike Knubel. Here's Larry Regan with some nice moves. Hey, here's Mario. He does look like Bellamy. Darren McCarty. Hey, you know, this looks like his Stanley Cup winning goal. Hey, watch Gretzky here. Hey, this looks like the one Bobby scored against the Flames. Hey, watch, look, it's the same goal. The two of the greats, just the same. Pete Mihaljevic tucks one by my buddy Gary Smith. Dallas Stars' Mike Bonanno with some nice ones. Ray Whitney scores a nice one here. Bonanno holds, and slips it along the ice. Peter Klima, one of the nicest ones you'll ever see. Worst helmet ever. There is no more famous goal in hockey than Bobby Orr's goal against the Blues. Hey, kids, let me tell you about Bobby. He won the Rookie of the Year, 2 Art Ross trophies, 8 Norris trophies for best defenseman, a record never to be broken, 2 Conn Smythes, and 2 Hart trophies. The one year, the last year I coached him, get this, he had 46 goals, 89 assists, and get this, plus 128. And he was the only defenseman to win the scoring title, and he did it twice. He was MVP of the 76 Canada Cup. He could do it all. Score, hit, block shot, fight. In 6 seasons, he had over 100 minutes in penalties. He was no sweetheart, and he could make plays.
Into the lead, 1-0. That was remarkable, Bobby's 4th goal of this series.
Now, this goal against Atlanta was a classic. Now, watch this. He's killing the penalty. Yeah, he puts on the jets. Sucks the defenseman and the goalie into the corner and then tucks it home. And look at that. He puts his head down because he knows he's embarrassed the other team. But of all of his goals, this one was the most famous.
Sanderson tried a shot that was wide and Keenan cleared it but not out. Bobby Orr behind the net to Sanderson. Orr! Bobby Orr! Scores in the Boston Bruins!
Lenny had 2 great playoff goals. This one wins it for the Leafs in Game 7 in overtime against the Islanders. Had a broken wrist, too.
Now Turnbull clears it ahead to McDonald. McDonald ready to shoot. He scores!
McDonald wins it! The Leafs win it!
And the Leafs win it!
Then in Calgary, everybody wanted Lenny to get a ring. Watch this quick wrist shot upstairs over Patrick Waugh's shoulder.
Coming in as Lou. Gilvendike center net. They got scores! Danny McDonald! Back to one.
Yeah, and as usual, Dougie clinches it with this one.
Here's Gilmore coming in. The backhand, a rebound. He scores! Gilmore gets that goal.
And Lanny finally gets his ring. Way to go, Lanny boy. Hey, I know all you Leaf fans remember this one. Game one against the Blues, and Cujo was great as usual. Time as usual, Dougie comes through.
Borshevsky, it is Gilmore waiting, waiting around the net, waiting, he's open. Gilmore, solo down.
Way to go, Dougie.
In a second overtime period.
Darren McCarty got one of the prettiest goals ever in the playoffs. Hey, Darren's known mostly for a grinding type play, taking the body. Blocking shots. But in the finals in 97 against Philly, he scored this beauty. I have to say it, I've never seen a nicer goal ever scored. This was a Stanley Cup winner. What a goal. Way to go, Darren. Hey, folks, don't blink on this one. Habs are down by one in the third, and Mailey ties up the game. Now, you remember this in overtime. Watch this right off the faceoff.
Anything can happen early here. From the faceoff, McPhee brings it in with Stroman. He scores!
How right JD was. Hey, 9 seconds, a record that still stands today.
9 seconds is all it took.
It's the Islanders and Philly. Boy, they're in the finals, and it was a tough go. Hey, you better keep your head up in this series, I'll tell you. Game six, and in the third, Paddock ties the game up at four. Bobby Nystrom becomes a hero with one of the most famous goals in hockey.
The pass to Nystrom.
Yeah, what a feeling. Moments to live forever.
You know, I'm going to tell you folks a few things that happened when I played. You won't believe this, but when two guys would fight, they'd go and sit in the same penalty box. Believe it or not, sometimes they'd have a policeman between them, but mostly they'd just sit there. So they started yapping. Boy, you should have seen some of the fights in the penalty box. And another thing, and I know you all know this, you've seen the pictures. Can you imagine goalies playing without a mask? Boy, they were iron men. Let me tell you, I've seen some awful cuts bang right between the eyes. They go out, broken nose, eyes swelling. They go out, get stitched up, blood's coming down. They go out. They were tough guys back in those days. They are now, too, though.
I gone through my whole junior career, first couple years of pro without a serious injury. My wife presented me with a child the night before. A premature child, weighed 6 pounds, very tough night, and I never went to bed all night. And the first shift down the ice, Red Berenson was a great American League player. He comes down in grapes. And I wasn't sharp that night, and usually when a player come down in grapes, I felt I had to be sharp to bail us out. And anyway, he danced around grapes like I expected and let a routine shot go, and I missed it. And that was the first time I got seriously injured. I lost all my teeth and 40 stitches. And I want to thank you, or else I would
have been good.
I would never been a complete hockey player.
Yeah. Pro made you go back, didn't he? Joe Crozier?
I got stitched up and finished the game.
You know, they had to be nuts playing without a mask. punt gets nailed. Not only do you have to watch the pucks, but the sticks can get you too. Bobby Perreault, he gets one right in the face. Bauer gets one twice by John Ferguson. What's going on? Plot is sliced open. Nowadays, the goalies need a mask. And they even get stuck in the cage. Cujo gets it from Wendell. The Scottish guy, Healy. Malarchuk, boy, does he get it. Waugh gets it. Holy, that goalie. Hey, look, he doesn't even flinch. Glenn Healy again. Waugh again, too. Richard Brodeur takes it off the mask. Kelly Rudy. Nice dent. I don't care what anybody says. If a goalie comes out, you shouldn't be able to hit him. I guess these guys feel different. Hasek gets nailed by Jones. Yeah, in the old days, it was the same thing. They still got run. Watch the nets back then, eh? They got the post in them. They don't move. Probert on Keynes. Defoe takes one for the team. Gosselin takes a header. Leafs run Lalime. Hasek's run by the Flyers again. Boy, Jacques Plante takes a beating. Hey, Bauer hurt his back on this one. Sometimes goalie can get revenge, though. Ekstahl on Patty. Corey Schwab takes out the Rangers. Kirby on the Devils. What did I do? What did I do? And now for some great saves. Belfour on Hall. Boucher. Nabokov with a nice one. Richter on the Jets. Bissett, nice one. Fuhrer, two on the Leafs. My buddy Brucey Gamble with a nice one. Glenn Hall with two beauties. Hasek with a nice kick save. Rudy Ruggs, the Whalers' Dineen. Reese with a Hasek-like save. Caron with a great glove save. Richter again. Tugnod with a spinorama save on the Pens. Cloutier robs Ryan Smith. Plott with four great saves. Boy, that guy can move. Hey, look how small the equipment is. Woken makes three in a row. Hasek again. Miracle with a Hasek save. Osgood off the post and save. Poche knocks it away just in time. Bauer with a nice stick save. Do that today, and it's a penalty. Eddie Johnson with a nice glove save. Harry Lumley robs the Leafs. Dunham stones him. DiPietro on Modano. Turk stacks the pads. Hey, Ranford with a classic in the finals. Rhodes knocks that puck away. Hey, Richter comes out of nowhere. Devo had to be careful here. Kenny Chadwick robs the Habs twice. Cesar Maniego stones the Wings. Jacques Plante, nice glove save. Van Beesbrouck. Defoe. Tugnut on the Bolts. Turk gets it moving. Donnie Simmons with two on the Rocket. That's a penalty today, Donnie. Jeremy Roenick is a loving guy. Watch these players run into each other. It looks funny, but these guys aren't expecting it, and boy, you can get your bell rung pretty good. Deschuk says they said.
Luan Gotti bumps into Van Imp. They collide with each other.
Even the ref and linesmen have to look out.
Now the Sharks are able to take control. Heavy hit, far side by Chris Simon.
Carry.
Lead pass breaking into the clearance.
Hey, that's embarrassing. Poor Rob. Well, at least it was in the warm-up. It can happen to the best of them. Watch the door, Pavel. That's what I call a tough change. Hey, Ted, that seat cost $200 today. Tommy Webster had a tough time in L.A. That's ready to go. Zamboni broken down. Hey, we never had that problem in the old days.
You know, for me, there's nothing in sports like a seventh game of a Stanley Cup playoffs. You can feel electricity in there. It's like a heavyweight championship fight, and nothing is harder on the coach's nerves, I'll tell you.
Hey, watch how many strange goals there are in this game. Nieuwendijk makes it 1-0. Robert Norrmark ties it up. McKinnis with a blaster. It's in and out. Hey, Terry Criss wants to have them have another look at it.
Here's the shot again by McKinnis. Boomed it just inside.
It's off Roberts, and it's 2-1. Trevor Linden sifts one along the ice, and it's 2-all. This one goes off a stick, and Mullen makes it 3-2. Hey, Doug Lister's pass goes off a flame, and it's all tied up, and we're going to overtime. Watch these saves by Vernon. They're unbelievable.
Pass up on the right side with Smith. He's going in all the way. Oh, again. Here comes Tanny. He got a chance. Another great save. How can he keep doing this?
Vernon kept the Flames in the game, and watch what happens.
They're after it again. Paprinski going in. Score! The Calgary Flames have finally done it. Not a pitcher goal. It was centered by Paprinski. It hit a skate in front.
All right, now the Sabres are up 3-2. They're beating the Pens by a goal with less than a minute to go. Mario to the rescue, ties it up, and off to overtime. Marty Strachan, he gets the winner, and they're heading back to Buffalo for Game 7. Now it's overtime in Game 7. Kasparaitis just puts it on the net, and it handcuffs Hasek. Hey, boy, is he excited or what? I always told my players in overtime, just put it on the net. You never know what's going to happen.
David
the defending Stanley Cup champions, Penguins, thought they were going to breeze by the Islanders.
They score!
Well, it was game seven, and the Pens were down by two. Ron Francis to the rescue with two goals to send the game into OT. Hey, David Bullock gets the goal of his career.
They come 2-on-1. Bullock shoots, scores! David Bullock, Islanders! And there'll be a new Stanley Cup champion in 1993.
Game 7 between the Islanders and the Cap would go to 4 overtimes. Hatcher makes it 1-0. Trotche ties it up at 2.
It goes Trotche, scores! Trotche scoring for New York.
In overtime, Mason with a big save on Bassan. And imagine, in the fourth overtime, Patty LaFontaine wins it. Boy, that was a heartbreaker for Mason.
LaFontaine shot. He scores! LaFontaine at the blue line. Here in the fourth overtime. Firing the shot and winning the series. Fourth overtime period, and the Islanders pour off the bench.
Hey, my buddy Dale Hunter comes up big in Game 7 versus the Flyers. He scores to make it 4-3. After Brad Marsh ties it up, they go into overtime where Hextall makes a beauty save. But Dale gets a nice pass from Murphy.
Hunter speaking through the middle, the pass. Hunter's in on the breakaway!
Dale then, and this is Dale now with his brother Mark, their coach and GM of the London Knights. Here are some of the Knights' beauty goals, starting with Brandon Prust, Jordan Foreman, hey, Danny Savette with two nice moves. David Boland. Prust again. Brian Rodney. Dylan Hunter. Kelly Thompson. You have to have good goaltending to win the Memorial Cup, that's for sure. Two nice ones by Coleman and a diving save by Denny. Hey, you know, Dale Hunter teams, they're going to play the body. Tonight's won the Memorial Cup and had a record of 59 wins, 7 losses, and 2 ties, if you can believe. And set a record with a 31-game unbeaten streak. Now here's one of my favorites, the Oilers' first-round draft pick, Robbie Shrimp. One of my drafts. Boy, he can skate, handle the puck, and as you can see, he's got a great shot. The Knights were led by the Ducks' number one round pick, Corey Perry. Hey, watch this guy. Watch these moves, boy, they're unbelievable. Best junior in hockey, as far as I'm concerned. All right, you remember the time I said when Samsonov won Rookie of the Year? You remember that? And I said, yeah, well, Joe Thornton didn't win it. I said, check with me in about 5 years. Who would you rather have, Samsonov or Thornton? Well, mark my words, out of all the rookies coming into the NHL this year, Corey Perry is eventually going to be the best.
You know, when I played the game, there would be one, maybe two guys that could really hammer the puck, but everybody can hammer the puck now. I don't know, it must be those sticks, the $200 sticks. But the funny thing is, the hardest shot in hockey is Al MacInnis. I'll tell you, he can hum them, and he has a wooden stick. I remember one of his shots. It's a legend.
Now, that shot that you let with poor Mike Liut, I mean, tell us about that one. That was on Letterman, that was on Johnny Carson, it was everywhere.
Well, that's when it certainly took off, my shot around the league, and, you know, they had a lot of highlight films. I think it was shot of the week, and I just came over the red line, and it was outside the blue line. I took the shot, and I caught all of it, and that's St. Louis rink. It's dark in there some nights, so I don't know if he saw it or what, but went off his head, and the good thing about it, it ended up in the net. So.
Yeah, that's right. Boy, he got all of this one. When he tees them up, no one could hammer it like Al. Billy Smith still hasn't seen it. Man, could he blast it. There's Boom Boom Jeffrey on. The Leafs' Mike Walton. The Big M with a big shot. Dicky Duff. Stefan Rishank puts it to the net. Hey, look, watch. Ron Ellis hammers one. Hey, my old roommate, Jim McKinney, this is his first goal. Rod Gilbert with a blaster. Rick Martin against the Habs. Here's Reggie Leafs with one against the Leafs. Yuri Slager with a bullet. McLean. Lindros. Jason Woolley. Paul Kariya. Danielle Alverson. Tony Amonte, Peter Bundra, Dimitra, Brett Hull, Beauty, Chris Gratton, Paul Kariya again, and Bundra again. You know, slap shots are pure power. Now, backhands, you gotta have sweet hands. Backhands are murder on goalies. They don't know if the player's going top corner along the ice, pull it to his forehand or what. Half the time, the player doesn't know either. I'm telling you, boy, they drive goalies nuts. The Big M. Armstrong. Travis Green. Hey, my buddy Chris Simon. Here's Solani with a beauty top corner. Yuri with a spin around. Colin Forbes, top corner. Hey, Cullen, short side. Here's Cam Neely, a little spinorama backhand. Samsonov. Henri Pocket Rocket Richard. Davey Keon. A beauty. Owen Nolan. Bonanno, short side. Joe Murphy with one top corner. Now watch Theodore, he has a 130-footer. That's the longest backhand in the world. Beauty! Every game in this series was a battle.
Here's the neutral zone hit by Konstantinov. Toronto's trying to be physical, trying to be sensible about it.
Pino and Potvin had something going. Game 7, and Anderson makes it 1-0. Eisenberg makes it 1-1. Burr makes it 2-1 wings. Bob Rouse makes it 2-2. Dallas Drake puts the wings in the lead. But Dougie ties the game late in the third, and we head to OT.
After the puck, back to center. Hammers one backhand for Toronto. Clark shoving it to the corner. Out front again, Rouse. Scores! Scores! The Leafs win it!
The Leafs defeat the Detroit Red Wings in overtime. 2 minutes, 35 seconds in. This has been an unbelievable...
Is Pat happy or what? After Fleury won Game 6 in OT, Game 7 was back in the Saddle Dome. And the Flames come out storming. 2-0, Joe Nieuwendyk. 3-0, Theo Fleury.
3 minutes left in this first period.
This one is a killer. Iesa gets his first one of the game. Anderson cuts the lead to 1.
Here's McTavish.
Iesa gets his second of the game, and Vernon is hot.
Tikkanen was in front, and Mike Vernon's upset. They'll try it again.
Semenov puts the Oilers ahead in the third. But with 2 minutes left, the Flames tie it up with a goal by Stern.
They score! Rod Stern!
And in OT, Tikkanen gets the hat trick.
A couple of goals for Esa Tikkanen, 6 in the series. Shoot, scores! Esa Tikkanen has won it for the Oilers.
All right, it's Game 7 versus the Stars. Doesn't it always seem these two teams meet in the playoffs? Hey, Cujo was great. Hey, he's keeping them alive. Now watch Marchment dangle here. After the goal, watch the player try to kiss Todd right on the lips. A smacker. Are they happy or what? Hey, this one was a heartbreak for the Senators. Boy, I tell you, there was some good hits. And great goaltending in this series. It's Game 7 and the Sens are up by 1. Yashin wins the draw, but puts it to the top corner on Ron Tugnutt. And we're tied at 2 going into the overtime. Tugnutt played great all series, but Derek Plant's slap shot pops out of his glove and into the net for the winner. Like I said, in overtime, just shoot the puck. Time for more hits. Okay, folks, it's that time again. Now, if you don't like what's coming up and you know what's coming up, go out in the kitchen and have some tea. Now, we're going to start with one of the best and two of my favorites, Ty and Probert. Bobby Probert, boy, him and Ty had some beauties. Let's see one. You're going to love it. Okay, folks, it's in Madison Square Garden. It's Ty Domi and Bobby Probert. I'll tell you, folks, you couldn't believe this one. It was the hottest ticket to get in New York. Everybody wanted to get it. It was like the heavyweight championship fight. Two good guys going here. Watch how Probert holds his head up. Ty, a little guy, he's like a little bull terrier in there. Boy, they were really throwing them, I'll tell you. Two great guys. It's the Boston Gardens and Montreal Canadiens and the Boston Bruins. Hey, folks, things were really tough in this series, I'll tell you. Hadn't been any fights or that. For some reason, Scotty put out all his tough guys. I put out all my tough guys. I remember I took Peter McNabb off the ice. He said it was the happiest moment of his life. Anyhow, I knew something was going to happen. It was a great fight. As you see, Stan Jonathan and Pierre Bouchard, two tough guys. Well, that's it, folks. I can hardly believe it's over. I love doing these for you, and I hope you love them too. Lord willing, we'll be back to do it next year. Now, listen, I've got some of my favorite plays coming up. I want you to pump it up, put up the volume, and make some noise. See ya, folks. You know, there's a couple of terms I want to get straightened out. I remember McLean were on Coach's Corner,
And I remember that commercial they had. They had the guy hitting the puck up in the air as they walked out. And the guard said, boy, he could really dangle. And I said to McLean, you know, they're all wrong. That doesn't mean dangle. And the truck even put in dangle means something hanging and everything. Dangle, as everybody knows in hockey, means you can really fly out there with the puck. He can dangle. And I remember Muckler, come on, John Muckler, come on. I said, ask John. So he asked him, and he said, you can skate fast. So dangle means dangle with that puck.
So you got all that, eh? A dangle is when a player motors with the puck. Like Berard. Watch Denny Savard. Bertuzzi, a dangle and a straight arm. A Russian rocket, Pavel Bure. Hey, Samsonov, a dangle and a how's she going? The Avs, Corbet. Tchaikovsky. Rosie Raziska. Hey, even back in the 40s, they could dangle. Hey, funny looking at the dark ice, eh? Hall of Fame, Doug Harvey shows some speed and a nice shot. Niedermeyer blows by the Bruins defense. Naslund, hey, this is not a dangle, but I wanted to show it anyway. Now this is a dangle. Okay, not much of a dangle, but a nice one. Jean Beliveau. A beauty and Dan. Meyer with a classic Bobby Orr rush. Beauty. Drury. Hey, here's one of my favorites, Patrick Marleau with an end-to-ender. D.V. Eiserman, now this is a hockey player's hockey player. Ex-Peterborough Pete, little Stevie Wonder can do it all. He can dangle, he can handle a puck with the best of him, and boy, can he score. Watch these beauty goals. Yeah, and I'll tell you another thing. He's the most respected hockey player in the game today. The two-time Stanley Cup winner has played 190 playoff games and has 181 points. Not too shabby, eh? He's one of the best and one of my favorites of all time, Stevie Wonder Eiserman. Hey, when you think of a wrist shot, you think of Burnaby's Joe Sakic. If anybody had a better wrist shot in the history of the NHL, I haven't seen it. Hey, his wrist shot explodes. Know how he got it? I'll tell you how. You know, I asked Joe, I said, Joe, how'd you ever get that great wrist shot? Well, he tells me. He was down in the basement. He'd have pails of puck. Whatever he shot at, it was aluminum or something. So his dad would be upstairs in the living room reading the paper, and if Joe stopped shooting, he wouldn't hear the noise. Then he'd say, Joe, what are you doing? Joe would have to get back to shooting. Hour after hour, he'd shoot it, and that's how he got the great wrist shot. Joe's a two-time Stanley Cup winner and a gold medal winner, too. He's won the Lady Byng, I won't hold that against him, and a Hart Trophy in 2001. Nice pass to Raymond. And another nice pass to Raymond. Guys ask me, who way back could play in the NHL today? I always say the Rocket for sure, Belleville, Hall, and Gordie Howe. But the more I watch tapes of Timmy Horton, I would put him up in that category too. He's one of the most underrated players in the NHL of all time, as far as I'm concerned. He was one of the best carrying the puck, and he could dish it off. He was a great skater and one of the strongest players ever to play the game. Timmy loved to rush for the puck, and when you rush for the puck, you better not cut into center ice. This hit on Timmy by Bill Gazma is one of the most vicious hits of all time. Poor Timmy broke his jaw and leg on this one hit. But he came back and played the next season. The four-time Stanley Cup champion played 24 seasons in the National Hockey League. Only Messier and Hal have played more. Hey, he can hammer a puck as well. Timmy was one of the all-time greats as far as I'm concerned and one of the most all-time underrated. I only met him a couple of times at training camp, and he was one of the nicest guys I've ever met. Starting off with two beauties by JR. Boy, they're gonna love him in LA. Bill Guerin with a funny one. And here's a Russian rocket, Pavel Bure, with some sweet hands. Forsberg from in close. Donato. Pavel, Dmitry, hold, and Rusin. Dickie Duff with a beauty. Mike York with a nice move. Dougie, wait. Dadzuk walks in, nice. Bob Airy on the Sharks. Peter Forsberg with some nice moves. Hey, somebody hit him. John Beliveau looks like Mario here. Or should I say Mario looks like Beliveau? Here's a rocket in a classic. All Korea, boy, can he dangle. Here's Mike Knievel. Here's Larry Regan with some nice moves. Hey, here's Mario. He does look like Beliveau. Darren McCarty. Hey, you know, this looks like his Stanley Cup winning goal. Hey, watch Gretzky here. Hey, this looks like the one Bobby scored against the Flames. Hey, watch. Look, it's the same goal. The two of the greats, just the same. Pete Mihaljevic tucks one by my buddy Gary Smith. Dallas Stars Mike Bonanno with some nice ones. Ray Whitney scores a nice one here. Bonanno holds, 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 and slips it along the ice. Peter Klima, one of the nicest ones you'll ever see. Worst helmet ever.
You know, when I played the game, there would be one, maybe two guys that could really hammer the puck, but everybody can hammer the puck now. I don't know, it must be those sticks, the $200 sticks. But the funny thing is, the hardest shot in hockey is Al MacInnis. I'll tell you, he can hum them, and he has a wooden stick. I remember one of his shots. It's a legend.
Now, that shot that you let with poor Mike Liut, I mean, tell us about that one. That was on Letterman, that was on Johnny Carson, it was everywhere.
Well, that's when it certainly took off, my shot around the league, and, you know, they had a lot of highlight films. I think it was shot of the week, and I just came over the red line, and it was outside the blue line. I took the shot, and I caught all of it, and that's St. Louis rink. It's dark in there some nights, so I don't know if he saw it or what, but went off his head, and the good thing about it ended up in the net. So.
Yeah, that's right. Boy, he got all of this one. When he tees them up, no one could hammer it like Al. Billy Smith still hasn't seen it. Man, could he blast it. There's Boom Boom Jeffrey on. The Leafs' Mike Walton. The Big M with a big shot. Dicky Duff. Stefan Richey puts it to the net. Hey, look, watch. Ron Ellis hammers one. Hey, my old roommate, Jim McKinney, this is his first goal. Rod Gilbert with a blaster. Rick Martin against the Habs. Here's Reggie Leafs with one against the Leafs. Yuri Slager with a bullet. McLean. Lindros. Jason Woolley. Paul Kariya. Danielle Alverson. Tony Amonte. Peter Bundra. Dimitra. Brett Hall. Beauty. Chris Gratton. Paul Kariya again. And Bundra again. You know, slap shots are pure power. Now, backhands, you gotta have sweet hands. Backhands are murder on goalies. They don't know if the player's going top corner along the ice, pull it to his forehand, or what. Half the time, the player doesn't know either. I'm telling you, boy, they drive goalies nuts. The Big M. Armstrong. Travis Green. Hey, my buddy Chris Simon. Here's Solani with a beauty top corner. Yuri with a spin around. Colin Forbes, top corner. Hey, Colin, short side. Here's Cam Neely, a little spinorama backhand. Samsonov. Henri Pocket Rocket Richard. Davey Keon. A beauty. Owen Nolan. Bonanno, short side. Joe Murphy with one top corner. Now watch Theodore. He has a 130-footer. That's the longest backhand in the world. Beauty. All right, sitting in my beautiful chair here, I've seen some great playoff goals, let me tell you. And I've got some of my favorites and some of my not-so-favorites, if you know what I mean. Me and the Bruins, Guy Lafleur, Scotty Bowman, and the Canadiens. Nifty Middleton puts us up one sip. Watch Savard make a big save on my buddy Stan Jonathan. They tie it up in a power play. What else? Cashman played unbelievable in this series. He puts us up 2-1. Then he walks out and puts it under Dryden's arm. We're up 3-1. And they cut it to 3-2 in a power play. What else again? Then Key feeds Savard on another power play, and it's tied at 3. Unbelievable, the power plays. In the third, Ricky Middleton scores to make it 4-3. Way to go, Nifty. And here is a play that sent me on the road to Coach's Corner.
How the play started now, and you picked it up in your own end, right?
Yeah, I gave it to Lemaire, and Lemaire went inside the blue line about maybe...
Looked offside to me, too.
No, it wasn't. About 25 feet inside, drop it back, and Gilles Gilbert was in the net.
Yeah, he'd played great up until then.
He still talked to me about it in Quebec City.
Does he? Yeah. Well, right along the ice again. When you get in there, you hummer all along the ice all the time. Did
close my eye again.
Yeah, again. Yeah. That guy's always close his eye.
I still say it was offside. to look at some more great playoff goals. Looks like Mario said, look, I'm going to get this puck, and I'm going to score, and nobody's going to stop me. And he did it. A year to the day, watch this classic on the Bruins' top corner again.
Trying to fool Mark and does. Look out, scores. Have you ever seen such finesse?
Now my buddy Bobby Schmutt sips one home.
Up to Shepard with Marcotte. Shepard moving in. Center for Schmutt. He scores!
I love those Boston crowds. They love the Bruins, and that's my number one fan.
Gilmore, Fleury.
Fleury gets a nice one and sends the Battle of Alberta to game seven.
Messier gets it away. Here's Fleury looking for his first goal of the series. Scores!
Nice slide. That's okay after OT goes. Are they happy or what? Bill Morocco scores his last goal to win the Stanley Cup, just like the tragically hip song says. Howie Meeker puts it in front, and Billy pops it home for the winner. This one is the greatest comeback of all time in any sport, as far as I'm concerned. I was doing the color. Darrell Evans wins it in overtime. The King scored unbelievable five straight goals in the third to tie it up. I was doing the color with Bob Cole. I never heard a crowd go as nuts as that.
Fashion here tonight, the greatest comeback that I can remember in Stanley Cup play.
René Robert scores against Bernie Perron, and you remember this one. This was a famous fog game. Great shot. René put it along the ice, and Perron lost it in the fog. Way to go, René. Peter Stastny scores a winner in overtime in Game 7. You know, they talk about the Battle of Alberta. The Battle of Quebec was just as vicious, if not more so. Hey, speaking of the Battle of Alberta, watch the great one score in overtime. It was shorthanded, no less. Hey, it helped the Oilers sweep the Flames.
Gretzky going in, Suter trying to get back. Gretzky with his nutty score!
Watch him wire this one. That's a smoker top corner.
It's a shorthanded goal.
Brett Hull, was his foot in the crease or not? Brett with the winner in game six of the final. Hey, the rule that year was if your skate is in the crease, it was no goal. Hey, I don't know. I said it was in the crease. Yeah, so what? He was in the crease. What's the difference? Dallas wins the cup. There is no more famous goal in hockey than Bobby Orr's goal against the Blues. Hey, kids, let me tell you about Bobby. He won the Rookie of the Year, two Art Ross trophies, eight Norris trophies for best defenseman, a record never to be broken, two Conn Smythes, and two Hart trophies. The one year, the last year I coached him, get this, he had 46 goals, 89 assists, and get this, plus 128. And he was the only defenseman to win the scoring title, and he did it twice. He was MVP of the 76 Canada Cup. He could do it all. Score, hit, block shot, fight. In six seasons, he had over 100 minutes in penalties. He was no sweetheart, and he could make plays.
Into the lead, 1-0. That was remarkable, Bobby's fourth goal of this series.
Now this goal against Atlanta was a classic. Now watch this, he's killing a penalty. Yeah, he puts on the chest, sucks the defenseman and the goalie into the corner, and then tucks it home. And look at that, He puts his head down because he knows he's embarrassed the other team. But of all of his goals, this one was the most famous.
Sanderson tried a shot that was wide and Keenan cleared it, but not off. Bobby Orr behind the net to Sanderson. Orr! Bobby Orr! Scores and the Boston Bruins have won the Stanley Cup. Orr putting it in with a closed door. And what does the Boston...
Lenny had two great playoff goals. This one wins it for the Leafs in Game 7 in overtime against the Islanders. Had a broken wrist, too.
Now Turnbull clears it ahead to McDonald. McDonald ready and shoots. He scores!
McDonald wins it! The Leafs win it!
And the Leafs win it!
Then in Calgary, everybody wanted Lenny to get a ring. Watch this quick wrist shot upstairs over Patrick Waugh's shoulder.
Coming in as Lou Gilladyke center net. And that scores! Lenny McDonald! One.
Yeah, and as usual, Dougie clinches it with this one.
Here's Gilmore coming in. The backhand, a rebound. He scores! Gilmore gets that goal.
And Lenny finally gets his ring. Way to go, Lenny boy. Hey, I know all you Leaf fans remember this one. Game one against the Blues, and Cujo was great as usual. Time as usual, Dougie comes through.
Borshevsky, it is Gilmore waiting, waiting around the net, waiting, he's open! Gilmore! Solo time!
Way to go, Dougie!
In a second overtime period!
Darren McCarty got one of the prettiest goals ever in the playoffs. Hey, Darren's known mostly for a grinding type play, taking the body. Blocking shots. But in the finals in 97 against Philly, he scored this beauty. I have to say it, I've never seen a nicer goal ever scored. This was a Stanley Cup winner. What a goal. Way to go, Darren. Hey, folks, don't blink on this one. Habs are down by one in the third, and Mailey ties up the game. Now, you remember this in overtime. Watch this right off the faceoff.
Anything can happen early here. On the faceoff, McPhee brings it in with Stroman. He scores!
How right JD was. Hey, 9 seconds. A record that still stands today.
9 seconds is all it took.
It's the Islanders and Philly. Boy, they're in the finals, and it was a tough go. Hey, you better keep your head up in this series, I'll tell you. Game six, and in the third, Paddock ties the game up at four. Bobby Nystrom becomes a hero with one of the most famous goals in hockey.
A pass to Nystrom.
Yeah, what a feeling. Moments to live forever.
You know, for me, there's nothing in sports like a seventh game of a Stanley Cup playoffs. You can feel electricity in there. It's like a heavyweight championship fight, and nothing is harder on the coach's nerves, I'll tell you.
Hey, watch how many strange goals there are in this game. Neuendijk makes it 1-0. Robert Norrmark ties it up. McKinnis with a blaster. It's in and out. Hey, Terry Criss wants to have them have another look at it.
Here's the shot again by McKinnis. Moved it just inside.
It's off Roberts, and it's 2-1. Trevor Linden sifts one along the ice, and it's 2-all. This one goes off a stick, and Mullen makes it 3-2. Hey, Doug Lister's pass goes off a plane, and it's all tied up, and we're going to overtime. Watch these saves by Vernon. They're unbelievable.
Pass out of the way. He's going in all along. Oh, again. Here comes Tanny. He got a chance. Another great save. How can he keep doing this?
Vernon kept the Flames in the game, and watch what happens.
They're after it again. Paprzycki going in. Score. The Calgary Flames have finally done it. Not a pitcher goal. It was centered by Paprzycki. It hit him. Stayed in front.
All right, now the Sabres are up 3-2. They're beating the Pens by a goal with less than a minute to go. Mario to the rescue, ties it up, and off to overtime. Marty Straka, he gets the winner, and they're heading back to Buffalo for Game 7. Now it's overtime in Game 7. Kasparaitis just puts it on the net, and it handcuffs Hasek. Hey, boy, is he excited or what? I always told my players in overtime, just put it on the net. You never know what's going to happen. The defending Stanley Cup champions, Penguins, thought they were going to breeze by the Islanders.
They score!
Well, it was Game 7, and the Pens were down by 2. Ron Francis to the rescue with 2 goals to send the game into OT. Hey, David Bullock gets the goal of his career.
They come 2-on-1. Bullock shoots, scores! David Bullock! Islanders! And they'll be a new Stanley Cup champion in 1993.
Game 7 between the Islanders and the Cap would go to 4 overtimes. Hatcher makes it 1-0. Trottier ties it up at 2.
It goes Trottier! Scores! Trottier scoring for New York.
In overtime, Mason with a big save on Bassan. And imagine, in the 4th overtime, Patty LaFontaine wins it. Boy, that was a heartbreaker for Mason.
He scores! LaFontaine at the blue line here in the 4th overtime. Firing the shot and winning the series. 4th overtime period, and the Islanders pour off the bench.
Hey, my buddy Dale Hunter comes up big in Game 7 versus the Flyers. He scores to make it 4-3. After Brad Marsh ties it up, they go into overtime where Hextall makes a beauty save. But Dale gets a nice pass from Murphy.
Hunter speaking through the middle of the pass. Hunter's in on a breakaway!
Was Dale then. Every game in this series was a battle.
Here's a neutral zone hit by Konstantinov. Toronto's trying to be physical, trying to be sensible about it.
Dino and Potvin had something going.
Cicerelli has been a major thorn in the
Game 7, and Anderson makes it 1-0. Eisenberg makes it 1-1. Burr makes it 2-1 wings. Bob Rouse makes it 2-2. Dallas Drake puts the Wings in the lead. But Dougie ties the game late in the third And we head to OT.
After the puck, got to center. Rouse hammers one back in for Toronto. Clark shoving it to the corner. Out front again, Rouse. Scores! Scores! Well, the Leafs win it. The Leafs defeat the Detroit Red Wings in overtime. 2 minutes, 35 seconds in. This has been an unbelievable.
Is Pat happy or what? After Fleury won Game 6 in OT, Game 7 was back in the Saddle Dome. And the Flames come out storming. 2-0, Joe Nieuwendyk. 3-0, Theo Fleury.
3 minutes left in this first period.
This one is a killer. Iesa gets his first one of the game. Anderson cuts the lead to 1.
Here's McTavish.
Iesa gets his second of the game, and Vernon is hot.
Tikkanen was in front, and Mike Vernon's upset. They'll try it again.
Semenov puts the Oilers ahead in the third. But with 2 minutes left, the Flames tie it up with a goal by Stern.
They score! Rod Stern!
And in OT, Tikkanen gets the hat trick.
A couple of goals for Esa Tikkanen, 6 in the series. Shoot scores! Esa Tikkanen has won it for the Oilers.
All right, it's Game 7 versus the Stars. Doesn't it always seem these two teams meet in the playoffs? Hey, Cujo was great. Hey, he's keeping them alive. Now watch Marchman dangle here. After the goal, watch the player try to kiss Todd right on the lips. A smacker. Are they happy or what? Hey, this one was a heartbreak for the Senators. Boy, I tell you, there was some good hits. And great goaltending in this series. It's Game 7 and the Sens are up by 1. Yashin wins the draw, but puts it to the top corner on Ron Tugnutt. And we're tied at 2 going into the overtime. Tugnutt played great all series, but Derek Plant's slap shot pops out of his glove and into the net for the winner. Like I said, in overtime, just shoot the puck. Hi, folks. How you doing? Hey, this is how I watch a hockey game, just like you people do. I got my TV. I'm down my basement. I got my beautiful goldfish, as everybody knows. But most of all, I have my beautiful chair. This chair I've had since the 60s, way back 40. It's seen a lot of hockey games, and it's seen a few suns go down, too. You know, I remember, though, when I was unemployed. I didn't have a job, so I bought this when I was unemployed down in Rochester, New York. Never had a job, and I listened to Bobby Orr. You remember when he scored that great goal flying through the air? And I said, what am I going to do? I don't have a job. I couldn't get a job sweeping floors. I couldn't get anything. And I said, dear God, help me out here. Let me do something. Help me do. I made a comeback. And 4 years from the day I heard Bobby score that goal, I was coaching Bobby Orr. So thank you, God. I just wanted to say that. You kids say your prayers every night. Anyhow, back then they had hip picks, boy, you couldn't believe. Got them now, too. But we've got a few. You ready to go? Let's see those hip checks. Okay, here we go. These are classic hip checks from today and to the early 50s. Here's New York's Brad Park on Johnny Busek. Thank you. by my buddy Brian Marchman. Hey, don't think the Rocket couldn't dish it out too. Look, I gotta admit, the hip checks were flashy. But I'll tell you something. When you get caught in the trolley tracks, it's serious business. As you know, the trolley tracks are when you cut into center and you can't get out of the tracks. Hey, it's your nightmare and a defenseman's dream. And once you get in the trolley tracks, no mercy is shown. And here's what I call a suey pass. In other words, a suicide pass. You know, kids, if you look up and you see one of your teammates looking back for a pass at center ice, you know another guy's coming, don't give it to him. That's what we call a suicide pass. That's when they get hurt. You know, folks, one of the hardest hitters I've ever seen in my life is Bobby Bond when he played for the Toronto Maple Leafs. This guy used to come out and crunch him like you couldn't believe. Bawango, you couldn't believe it. You know, he taught me a valuable lesson when I was a rookie. I was standing around watching a fight. He come up behind me, put his arm around me, around the neck, started to choke me. Guys fell on me. I thought I was going to die. Nobody ever did that to me again. Thank you, Bobby. Thank you. But he's got some hits coming for you. Watch this.
You get a guy in the trolley tracks, and it was curtains.
It was a lot of fun. We had our wingers really helped a lot in those days, though. You know, we had those guys coming
back. Steer them in, eh?
And they could just cut those outside off for us, and Al would stand up a little bit, and the guy would have to turn into the center ice, and I'd be there.
Oh, Gonzo, I'll tell you, boy.
When Bobby Bond was on the ice, you better keep your head up. He was murder on center ice, and he was just as tough along the boards. As I found out in my rookie year, he could really throw them. Bobby Bond, one of the hardest hitters back in my day. Six foot three, 200 pounds, Rob Blake from Simcoe, Ontario, is the hardest hitter in the game today. Rob was a Norris Trophy winner in 1998 and a first-team All-Star that same year. Yeah, and he was also an anchor on the gold medal-winning Team Canada in the 2002 Salt Lake City Games. Hey, like Bond, you better keep your head up when Rob's on the ice. Hey, watch, he kind of backs into the players. If you were going to start a team and you could only pick one player to build your team around, Rob wouldn't be a bad choice, I'll tell you. Blake, the hardest hitter in hockey, now that Stevens is retired. Look at those eyes. The hardest hitter of all time, hands down, is 6'2", 215 pounds, Kitchener, Ontario native Scott Stevens. If you are cutting across center ice with Scott on the ice, you are asking for trouble. Scott is a three-time Stanley Cup champion, the 2000 Conn Smythe winner, and played in 13 All-Star games. And can you believe it? He never won a Norris Trophy. That's nuts. Scott made a lot of guys pay the price, I'll tell you. This is defense partner Brian Rafalski is forcing the Canes player to cut to the center. Scott sees this and makes his move. Hey, Scott and Eric had a thing going. In the 2000 playoffs, Eric was out for a long time with an injury. He came back for game 6 against the Devils. You know, I come on coach's corner and said Eric is nuts playing. And he better watch out because he's not sharp. And guys like Stevens are right in the thick of the battle. They're sharp. But watch what happened in game 7. Hey, Eric, come back next year. Scott Stevens, three-time Stanley Cup champion and the NHL's hardest hitter of all time.
You know, I'm going to tell you folks a few things that happened when I played. You won't believe this. But when two guys would fight, they'd go and sit in the same penalty box. Believe it or not, sometimes they'd have a policeman between them, but mostly they'd just sit there. So they started yapping. Boy, you should have seen some of the fights in the penalty box. And another thing, and I know you all know this, you've seen the pictures. Can you imagine goalies playing without a mask? Boy, they were iron men. Let me tell you, I've seen some awful cuts bang right between the eyes. They go out, broken nose, eyes swelling. They go out and get stitched up, blood's coming down. They go out. They were tough guys back in those days. They are now, too, though.
I've gone through my whole junior career, first couple years of pro without a serious injury. My wife presented me with a child the night before. A premature child, weighed 6 pounds, very tough night, and I never went to bed all night. And the first shift down the ice, Red Berenson was a great American League player. He comes down in grapes. And I wasn't sharp that night, and usually when a player come down in grapes, I felt I had to be sharp to bail us out. And anyway, he danced around grapes like I expected and let a routine shot go, and I missed it, and that was the first time I got seriously injured. I lost all my teeth and 40 stitches. And I want to thank you, or else I would
have been good.
I would never been a complete hockey player.
Yeah. Joe Crozier?
I get stitched up and finish the game.
You know, they had to be nuts playing without a mask. Puck gets nailed. Not only do you have to watch the pucks, but the sticks can get you too. Bobby Perreault, he gets one right in the face. Bauer gets one twice by John Ferguson. What's going on? Plot is sliced open. Nowadays, the goalies need a mask. And they even get stuck in the cage. Cujo gets it from Wendell. The Scottish guy, Healy. Malarchuk, boy, does he get it. Waugh gets it. Holy, that goalie. Hey, look, he doesn't even flinch. Glenn Healy again. Waugh again, too. Richard Brodeur takes it off the mask. Kelly Rudy. Nice dent. I don't care what anybody says. If a goalie comes out, you shouldn't be able to hit him. I guess these guys feel different. Hasek gets nailed by Jones. Yeah, in the old days, it was the same thing. They still got run. Watch the Nets back there, eh? They got the post in them. They don't move. Probert on Kings. Defoe takes one for the team. Gosselin takes a header. Leafs run Lalime. Essex run by the Flyers again. Boy, Jacques Plante takes a beating. Hey, Bauer hurt his back on this one. Sometimes goalie can get revenge, though. Ekstall on Patty. Corey Schwab takes out the Rangers. Kirby on the Devils. What did I do? What did I do? For more hits. Okay, folks, it's that time again. Now, if you don't like what's coming up and you know what's coming up, go out in the kitchen and have some tea. Now, we're going to start with one of the best and two of my favorites, Ty and Probert. Bobby Probert, boy, him and Ty had some beauties. Let's see one. You're going to love it. Okay, folks, it's in Madison Square Garden. It's Ty Domi and Bobby Probert. I'll tell you, folks, you couldn't believe this one. It was the hottest ticket to get in New York. Everybody wanted to get it. It was like the heavyweight championship fight. Two good guys going here. Watch how Probert holds his head up. Ty, a little guy, he's like a little bull terrier in there. Boy, they were really throwing them, I'll tell you. Two great guys. It's the Boston Gardens and Montreal Canadiens and the Boston Bruins. Hey, folks, things were really tough in this series, I'll tell you. Hadn't been any fights a lot. For some reason, Scotty put out all his tough guys. I put out all my tough guys. I remember I took Peter McNabb off the ice. He said it was the happiest moment of his life. Anyhow, I knew something was going to happen. It was a great fight. As you see, Stan Jonathan and Pierre Bouchard, two tough guys. Hey, watch these saves. Players think they're in. Not so fast, Kowalski. Cold egg robs Hernina. Hey, Brathwaite dives back in the nick of time. Barassa on LeClaire. Abishur on Morrison. Dunham dives back. Couchet robs Vincent. Hey, Cujo bails out my buddy Parchment. Gump Worsley with a beauty. Way to go, Gubber. Dennis DeJordy. Thibault on Ryan Smith. Shields. Frankenhauser, super. Byron with an unbelievable stick save on Delmar. Trevor Kidd with a nice glove save. Thibault again. Shields again. Jacques Blond knocks it down just in time. Eddie Johnson with a nice stick save. Gagair, remember this one in the playoffs a few years ago? Whoa! Shields with another great one. Salo. Lalime, nice one. Hey, Malarchuk, this is one of the best saves. Radford with a great one. Rhodes on LeClaire. Kiprasov with a great one. Lalime. Belongo, a diving save. Beaupre on Ricci. Too bad, Mike. Folks, I've seen them all, and to me, this guy was the greatest goalie who ever lived. Hey, Terry had black eyes here. That's why he's wearing the sunglasses. Hey, let's just go over Terry's stuff just to see how good he was. Most wins by a rookie goalie with 44, and the winner of the Calder Trophy, which is a rookie. Most shutouts in a career with 103. He won 44 games 2 years in a row. Unbelievable. Second only to Patrick Roy for career wins and games played. 4 Stanley Cups, 4 Veznas, and over 100 playoff games. He had 12 shutouts and an average of 2.5. Holy smokes. You know, Terry was a great guy. I was at a couple of training camps that he was at. And one day I was walking along the street with 3 of my minor league buddies, and he was walking the other way. He knew me, but he didn't know my name. He stopped and shook my hand. He made me feel so good. Anyhow, as far as I'm concerned, and a lot of people are concerned, the greatest goaltender who ever lived, Terry Sawchuk. If I had to win one game and I could pick any goalie playing to start for me, of course it would be Marty Brodeur. 3 Stanley Cups, a gold medal, world championship, rookie of the year, and back-to-back Veznas. The one thing I love about Marty, he always seems so cool in the net. He never panics. About this, over 400 wins, 75 shutouts, and believe me, in that playoff, Marty shined. In 140 games, Marty has 84 wins and has an average of 1.87. Unbelievable. When he's in a net, you always have a chance to win, that's for sure. Marty Brodeur, the best goalie playing in the National Hockey League. Okay, folks, time for some club saves from then and now, starting with Jerry Cheevers on Brad Park. Hey, here's Jerry in his rookie year with no mask. Richter. Lucci. Denny. Dunham. Cujo. Muir. Barrasso. Omen. Turek. A beauty by my buddy Gary Smith. Al Rollins with two nice ones. Johnny Bauer. Guy Hebert. Tyler Moss. Salo. Hasek. Richter again. Billy Radford. Weeks. Denis again. Snow. Jablonski. Eddie Johnson. Glenn Hall. Hey, here's Johnny Bauer again with two beauties. Mogan the Great One. Van Beesbrook. Salo. The Boolin Wall. Putfan. Roy. JVB again. Glenn Hall with two. Salo. Cujo off the post and into the glove. The long goal. Osgood. And now for some great saves. Belfour on Hall. Boucher. Nabokov with a nice one. Richter on the Jets. This set, nice one. Fuhrer, two on the Leafs. My buddy Brucey Gamble with a nice one. Glenn Hall with two beauties. Hasek with a nice kick save. Rudy Ruggs, the Whalers' Dineen. Reese with a Hasek-like save. Caron with a great glove save. Richter again. Tugnut with a spinorama save on the pins. Couchet robs Ryan Smith. Plunt with four great saves. Boy, that guy can move. Hey, look how small the equipment is. Vulcan makes three in a row. Hasek again. Miracle with a Hasek save. Osgood off the post and save. Boche knocks it away just in time. Bauer with a nice stick save. Do that today and it's a penalty. Eddie Johnson with a nice glove save. Harry Lumley robs the Leafs. Dunham stones him. DiPietro on Modano. Turk stacks the pads. A. Radford with a classic in the finals. Rhodes knocks that puck away. Hey, Richter comes out of nowhere. Devo had to be careful here. Eddie Chadwick robs the Habs twice. Cesar Maniego stones the Wings. Jacques Plante, nice glove save. Van Beesbrook. Defoe. Tugnut on the Bolts. Turk gets it moving. Donnie Simmons with two on the Rocket. That That's a penalty today, Donnie. Hey, folks, these shots are a goalie's nightmare, let me tell you. They hate these shots. All right, let's see them.
30 from 191 as it bounces in.
A clear in by Peter Stasny, right through Patrick.
Hey, watch it bounce on Patrick.
Up and over. Every goaltender's nightmare.
Paul Cavallini puts one off the glass and in. Yeah, here's a tough one on my buddy Brucey Gamble. Randy Wood on Frank Pietrangelo from center. It even happens to the best of them. Hey, poor Rascal. You know, when the puck takes a bounce like this at the last minute, there's not much a goalie can do. Hey, watch out for the post, Mike. Don't hurt yourself. Barassa gets his stick stuck. Hey, Patrick Waugh with a nice move on the great one. Hey, Patrick, you can't do that. Hey, Patrick gets hit. Blow the whistle, blow the whistle. Hey, tough going for Patrick. And he's not too happy.
You see the shot coming from the point. Don't really know on that.
Hey, Hextall gets a little upset here.
But he's certainly upset about it.
It's a beating frenzy right now.
Hey, that's what I like. Goalie with emotion.
Mike Mahovlich collects the winner on a rebound. Lumley didn't need this stick anymore that night anyway.
Hey, Jeremy Roenick is a loving guy. Watch these players run into each other. It looks funny, but these guys aren't expecting it, and boy, you can get your bell rung pretty good. Chuck says nice hit.
Luan Gotti bumps into Van Imp. They collide with each other.
Even the ref and linesman have to look out.
Now the Sharks are able to take control. Heavy hit, far side by Chris Simon.
Carry.
Lead pass breaking into the clear.
Hey, that's embarrassing. Poor Rob. Well, at least it was in the warm-up. It can happen to the best of them. Watch the door, Pavel. That's what I call a tough change. Hey, Ted, that seat cost $200 today.
Not enough room in the penalty box.
Tommy Webster had a tough time in L.A. That's ready to go. Zamboni broken down. Hey, we never had that problem in the old days. Well, that's it, folks. I can hardly believe it's over. I love doing these for you, and I hope you love them, too. Lord willing, we'll be back to do it next year. Now, listen, I've got some of my favorite plays coming up. I want you to pump it up, put up the volume, and make some noise. See ya, folks. and this is Dale now with his brother Mark, their coach and GM of the London Knights. Here are some of the Knights' beauty goals, starting with Brandon Prust, Jordan Foreman, hey, Danny Savette with two nice moves. David Boland. Prust again. Brian Rodney. Dylan Hunter. Kelly Thompson. You have to have good goaltending to win the Memorial Cup, that's for sure. Two nice ones by Coleman and a diving save by Denny. Hey, you know, Dale Hunter teams, they're going to play the body. The Knights won the Memorial Cup and had a record of 59 wins, 7 losses, and 2 ties, if you can believe. And set a record with a 31-game unbeaten streak. Now here's one of my favorites, the Oilers' first-round draft pick, Robbie Shrimp. One of my drafts. Boy, he can skate, handle a puck, and as you can see, he's got a great shot. The Knights were led by the Ducks' number one round pick, Corey Perry. Hey, watch this guy. Watch these moves, boy. They're unbelievable. Best junior in hockey as far as I'm concerned. All right, you remember the time I said when Samsonov won Rookie of the Year? You remember that? And I said, yeah, well, Joe Thornton didn't win it. I said, check with me in about 5 years. Who would you rather have, Samsonov or Thornton? Well, mark my words, out of all the rookies coming into the NHL this year, Corey Perry is eventually going to be the best. Hey, here's Joe Thornton's first goal. It's going to be many like that one, Joe. Just like a walk in the park. Hey, here's Joe with another beauty while sitting on the ice. Hey, Yammy Yager bats it in out of the air. Scotty Walker with a spinorama. All right. Dixon Ward. Ryan Rolson, top corner while falling down. Here's the Rockets' last NHL goal, a beauty backhand. Nicky Morris speeds in and tucks her home. Here's Lucky Loop with an overtime winner while laying on the ice. Here's Davey Keon roaring down the left wing, isn't he a beauty? Correa falls down, gets up, and bats in his own rebound. Yeah, he pushes down a duck and walks in and tucks her home. Savard walks through the whole Oilers and beats Fuhr. Adam Burke beats Rudy. Sorry, Kelly boy. And here's Jean Beliveau with some merry old moves. Two men on the Leafs. Hey, Yammy, he can handle a puck. I'll give him that point. 50-goal scorer, Hajduk. Watch Stevie Sullivan blow by the defense. Dougie goes top corner. Jeff Friesen, short side, top corner again. And here's Glenn Anderson with some beauty moves. Hatcher to Neuendijk to Grant Marshall. Dimitri, a beauty to Turgeon. To Lecavier, back to St. Louis, and it's in. Yeah, so the puck around, and it looks like an east-west game or something like that. Francis, no look, Jaeger. Todd Bertuzzi spin around to Olin. Hey, look at this great work by Correa. It's over to Solani. He's all by himself by the net where he should be. And in. Here's Madonna again. To Hall, to my buddy Muller. Way to go, Kirk. Doug Harvey, to Buescher-Curry, to Jean Beliveau. Dickie Duff, a backhand to Billy Harris, and in. Bubby McKell to my old teammate Bronco Horvath. Gerard sifts a nice one to Mal Holta. Elias to Sakara, back to Elias. It's a nice one. Eiserman on his back to Canoobal. Boy, what a guy. Kajak holds it and then slips it to my buddy Marty Reasoner. Pocket rocket to Nicky Moore, to the rocket, and it's in. Timmy Horton to Bobby Pulford to Eddie Shack. Hey, beauty. We start off with some beauty goals by Jaeger. Watch these beauties. I'll tell you something, when he wants to score, he can score, but sometimes he just doesn't feel like it. Bergman, nice move on the Rangers. Davey Keon with a beauty. How's she going? Howe with some sweet moves. Billy Guerin. Malfi with a beauty. Now for some one-handers, starting with Stefan Richie. Vinny on Boston. The king of one-handers, Zamenhof. Dougie Wade with a nice one. Here's another one by LeClaire. Zamenhof again on the Ducks. Hey, here's Joe Thornton's first goal. It's going to be many like that one, Joe. Just like a walk in the park. Hey, here's Joe with another beauty while sitting on the ice. Hey, Yami Yager bats it in out of the air. Scotty Walker with a spinorama. All right. Dixon Ward. Ryan Rolson, top corner while falling down. Here's the Rockets' last NHL goal, a beauty backhand. Nicky Moore speeds in and tucks her home. Here's Lucky Luke with an overtime winner while laying on the ice. Here's Davey Keon roaring down the left wing. Isn't he a beauty? Korea falls down, gets up, and bats in his own rebound. Yeah, he pushes down a duck and walks in and tucks her home. 7 walks through the whole Oilers and beats Fuhr. And a Bert beats Rudy. Sorry, Kelly boy. And here's Jean Beliveau with some merry old moves. Two men on the Leafs. Hey, Yami, he can handle a puck. I'll give him that, boy. 50-goal scorer, Hayduk. Watch Stevie Sullivan blow by the defense. Dougie goes top corner. Jeff Frazier, short side, top corner again. And here's Glenn Anderson with some beauty moves. Hatcher to Neuendijk to Grant Marshall. Dimitri, a beauty to Turgeon. To LeCavier, back to St. Louis, and it's in. Yeah, so the puck around, and it looks like an East-West game or something like that. Francis, no luck, Jaeger. Todd Bertuzzi spin around to Oland. Hey, look at this great work by Correa. It's over to Solani. He's all by himself by the net where he should be. And in. Here's Madonna again. To Hall to my buddy Muller. Way to go, Kirk. Doug Harvey to Buescher-Curry to Jean Beliveau. Dickie Duff, a backhand to Billy Harris, and in. Webby McKell to my old teammate Bronco Horvath. Berard sifts a nice one to Mal Holta. Elias to Sakara, back to Elias. It's a nice one. Eiserman on his back to Knubel. Boy, what a guy. Tejak holds it and then slips it to my buddy Marty Reasoner. Pocket rocket to Dickie Moore, to the rocket, and it's in. Timmy Horton to Bobby Pulford to Eddie Shack. Hey, beauty. We start off with some beauty goals by Jaeger. Watch these beauties. I'll tell you something, when he wants to score, he can score, but sometimes he just doesn't feel like it. Bergman, nice move on the Rangers. Davey Keon with a beauty. How's she going? Oh, with some sweet moves. Billy Guerin. Malfi with a beauty. Now for some one-handers, starting with Stefan Richie. Vinny on Boston. The king of one-handers, Zamenhof. Dougie Wade with a nice one. Here's another one by LeClaire. Zamenhof again on the Ducks.